Hello dear students, myself Ganga Bhosle, your statistics teacher. Today we are going to learn random variable. A variable denotes the numerical value of an outcome of a trial is called as random variable. For example, in tossing two coins, so we get here sample space S is HH, HT, TH, TT. And if X denote the number of tails turn up, capital X is equal to 0, 1, 2. Random variable is defined as the valued function on sample space S. Taking values on real line minus infinity to infinity is called as random variable. There are two types of random variables. First one is discrete random variable and second one is continuous random variable. First, discrete random variable. If a random variable capital X takes only finite, that is only finite or countably infinite values. Here the spelling of values is printed as VALVES, but there is a values, this is countably infinite values, then it is called as discrete random variable. Okay, for example, first one, number of students in the classroom. There are finite number of students in classroom, so we get here discrete random variable. Similarly, number of workers in the factory, number of children in the family. There are countable number of children in family, so here discrete random variable. Second one is continuous random variable. A random variable taking infinite or uncountable values, which is called as continuous random variable. For example, temperature of water, age of workers in factory, wages of workers. Now, probability distribution. The distribution of various values of probability over various values of a random variable is called a probability distribution. For example, if random variable X takes values x1, x2 up to xn with respective probabilities p1, p2 up to pn, then this distribution is called as probability distribution, where p1 plus p2 plus p3 up to plus pn is equal to 1. That is summation pi, I going from 1 to n is nothing but 1. Now we are see probability mass function. This probability mass function is denoted by P dot M dot F. This is short form of probability mass function is P dot M dot F. Now, let X be a discrete random variable. Taking values x1, x2, xn with probabilities p1, p2, pn respectively. Then, the function P of X is defined as P of xi, which is equal to P of x is equal to xi, which is equal to pi, where I going from 1 to n is called probability mass function. This is P dot m dot f, probability mass function, or simply probability functions of x under the conditions. First one condition is P of xi, which is equal to pi, is greater than or equal to 0 for, this is for for all I, positivity. And summation P of xi, which is equal to summation pi, I going from 1 to n is equal to 1. This is our additivity, that is summation. Okay, now probability density function. If f of x dx is the probability that the random variable x takes the values in small interval of magnitude dx such as x comma x plus dx or x minus dx by x comma x plus dx by x, then f of x is called probability density function, and this is the short form of p dot d dot f for probability density function. Of the continuous random variable x under the conditions, first one condition is f of x is greater than or equal to 0, second one is integration f of x dx is equal to 1. Similarly, for discrete random variable, the probabilities in case of continuous random variable cannot be calculated at a particular point which is 0, but it can be calculated for an interval. Second condition is integration f of x dx is equal to 1. That is, similar to discrete random variable, the probabilities in case of continuous random variable cannot be calculated at a particular point, that is, which is 0, but it can be calculated for an interval. Now, we see the most important point, that is mean and variance. The mathematical expectation of a random variable is its arithmetic mean, that is mean is equal to, which is denoted by e of x, expected value of x, which is equal to summation pi xi, okay, which is equal to summation x p of x, where x p of x is discrete probability distribution. Similarly, for mean is equal to e of x is equal to integration f of x dot x dx, where x f of x is continuously probability distribution. Then the variance of random variable x is given by, this variance is denoted by var of x, which is equal to sigma square. This symbol is called as sigma, which is equal to e of x minus e of x bracket square, that is e of x square minus e of x its whole bracket square. This is nothing but our variance. Now we see factorial. Factorial, this is the symbol for factorial. The product of first n natural numbers 1, 2, 3 up to n is called factorial of an integer n, which is denoted by n factorial, or this is n. For this, here we write factorial, that is n, that is n factorial is equal to 1 into 2 into 3 up to n. N factorial is equal to n into n minus 1, n minus 2 up to 3 into 2 into 1. Remember that 0 factorial is equal to 1, 1 factorial is equal to 1. Okay? N factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 factorial, which is equal to n into n minus 1 into n minus 1 factorial. 5 factorial. How to calculate 5 factorial? 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 5 into 4 is 20, 20 into 3 is 60, 60 into 2 is 120, 120 into 1 is 120. Similarly, we calculate 3 factorial. 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 1, which is equal to 3 into 2 is 6, 6 into 1 is 6. Okay? Now we see combination. A group of some or all of given objects without considering their order is called combination. The total number of combinations of n different objects taken R at a time is denoted by NCR. NCR. And this is given by the formula N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R its factorial when R is less than or equal to N. For example, the total number of combinations of two letters taken at a time out of three letters is from A, B, C. Three letter combination of two letters A, B, A, C, B, C. So here we have to calculate 3C2. Sorry, here the value of N is 3 and the value of R is 2. From this formula, 3C2, that is N factorial, is nothing but our 3 factorial divided by R factorial, that is 2 factorial, into N minus R, that is 3 minus 2 its factorial, which is equal to 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 3 minus 2 is 1 factorial, which is equal to 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 1 factorial is 1. And this 3 factorial, we write this 3 into 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial. 2 factorial, 2 factorial get cancelled. So here we get 3. 3 into 1, that is 3. Now note that is, this is our important formula. NCR is NC N minus R. NC0 is equal to 1 is equal to NCN, that is 3C3. The value of 3C3 is 1. 3C0. The value of 3C0 is also 1. NC1, that is 3C1, is equal to 3. NCN minus 1, that is 3C2, is equal to also 3. Okay? Now, here there are some exercises for you solve. Okay? I hope all of you understood. Random variable, its types of random variable, that is discrete random variable, continuous random variable. Then probability distribution, probability mass function, that is P dot M dot F. Probability density function, that is P dot D dot F. Mean E of X is nothing but our summation Pi Xi. Variance of X, VAR of X, which is equal to sigma square, is equal to E of X square minus E of X its whole bracket square. Then factorial, combination and their some notations. Okay? Thank you.